Well, good morning, Interbet fans, and welcome to the preview for Greyville. We're on the Polytrack 7-race program, Wednesday the 20th of September, and the first race is off at 1 o'clock. Obviously not able to fill the fields, but let's have a look. It does look like there's some big finds in this card, as I found last week. Found a couple of really nice price horses that ended up winning and running places, so things worked out well. 1 o'clock, 1,200 metres, a maiden plate, fillies and mares, and Cue the Rebel's got to be the bet of the day. Looks like an absolute homer. I know One Smart Cookie holds it on the Miss Olberg form, but I think Cue the Rebel, last time I thought it was a really, really bad ride by Fouree, and he was never really balanced and never got to the Gadsby runner, which was in front all the way. And I think that was pretty a nailer. I think this is an absolutely perfect race for Cue the Rebel. Should be able to win. One Smart Cookie does look like the danger of the rest of them. Maybe Queen Tassa, number four, will be an improver. One very good run on the poly. Have a close look at that one. Race two, maiden handicap, 1,600 metres. Well, when you have maiden handicaps, you find horses at the bottom of the weights that can win. And the one I found is 4 Grecian Palace. Gets weight from Madame Pompadour and gets weight from Courageous. Courageous looks to have a big chance coming from Joburg or from Merry Rating 75. Madame Pompadour got a mating rating of 79. And Grecian Palace, who's relatively unexposed, has only got a rating of 72. I think Grecian Palace is big, big value at 7-1. So they look like the three to fight it out. Race 3, merit rated handicap, 72 and 1,600 metres. The find of the race is number 1, High Velocity. The blinkers are off, but this horse goes the trip now. And the pullers obviously decided to take the blinkers off in order to get the horse to go the trip. I don't know that that's going to help, but let's see if that makes a big difference or not. So I do think High Velocity is a big runner, bred the way he is by Elusive Fort out of a Jetmaster mare. He should be going 2,000 metres this horse, but they've kept him to speed distances. I think the danger is number 7, Nazaire. This got good form, and the one run on the poly was not bad. I expect Nazaire to go very well. Exceed expectations, drawn 3, Daryl Daniels, 1 kilo over, might be a bridge too far. Race 4, merit rated 72, 1,600 metres, and my find of this race is number 6, Fine Admiral, another golf puller runner. Runs on every time, and certainly looks like got a chance. Its worst run was on the poly, which is worrying, but this looks like a good race for Fine Admiral, and at 25-1, certainly don't leave it out of anything. Mexican Pete, well, this is your favourite. This was one first time I'd given a merit rating of 90. Now, here's where I question the handicapper. Benny in the Arena ran second, okay, got beaten at 2.5 lengths. So that means that you would rate Benny in the Arena with a rating of 84. Well, I don't think Benny and the Arena is anywhere close to an 84. So this horse, Mexican Pete, got a horrible penalty or a horrible rating. It's very difficult for him in this type of field. Fish Eagle, I think, will go well. Course 1 from 1 and third run with Calvin Habib on a board it. And Aggressiva and Tashman both come into the race with a chance. Race 5, this is a merit rated handicap, and they go 1,900 metres. And the horse I found here, and I think it's absolutely home, is Love Bomb. If she gets a trip, Love Bomb is absolutely the right horse. I mean, she is third run after a race. She dropped 2 points. She's got class as mare, 6-year-old mare. And when you look at this field, if the 1,900 is within her compass, she's going to be very, very difficult to beat. I think that Sing for Winter obviously got a chance, and Magudu has won on it, and it's won on the course. Everything's in his favour. Our Sensation's got some form. A Magical Flight is your weak favourite, and obviously always in with a chance, but the 1,900 metres is a test for her as well, so it will be interesting to see how she goes. Reckless Love, well, She's won her three in a row and then ran fourth, wasn't beaten far. She's got to have a chance too here. So I just found Love Bomb. I thought that if she gets this trip, she's absolutely the right horse here. Race six, merit rated handicap fillies and mares. They go 1400 meters. And my top choice is number seven, National Star. Blinkers are on it, got good form, and I think that's absolutely perfect. Moodley gets an opportunity here and could go very well. Danger one, Vuluzana, definitely got a chance with Cabello aboard it. He knows how to ride it and has got glimpses of very good form. Morgan Le Fay, well, she loves the Polly. Ignore her last start. She was no good on the turf, and she's absolutely no good on the turf. And then the horse that might just upset the apple cart is 11, Acacia's Blossom. Born 11, not in his favour. The blinkers are on it, but she's by Fly Rally out of Hussein Mare. There's definitely room for improvement. Will she not need more ground? That's the interesting thing with her. I think that she needs definitely more ground. Kayleen, Strange Magic, and Aisling all come into the race with a chance that makes us the most difficult race on the card. Race 7, Merry Raid, Handicap Fillies and Mares, they got 1,200 metres. And Spirit of Flight, if she goes on the Polly, she's got a huge chance. Gerald Daniels gets a chance of getting some nice rides. But my top choice is 3, Pour Some Sugar on Me. Very good last, been running on. Gets La Hiba, claim 4. That's got to put it in with a huge chance here. Corchador, got 7 points penalty for winning his last 2 starts. And that's Light, which gives her a chance. And then Ola V, here's a horse that I've been following. Gets a 4-kilogram claimer. This filly's a lot better than she's rated. I tell you, she's come down in the ratings from in her last 3 runs from 75 to 64. She got to pop up somewhere, and at 25-1, I wouldn't leave her out of anything. So from me, James Goodman, and the whole Interbet team, as I said to you, find a couple, and we'll be back tomorrow.